thanks, Taylor. And yeah, as we've said before, everyone, there can be a little bit of problems with signal sometimes over the river, but nonetheless, we've followed this pair of hammerkops back to their nest, well, the half-built nest, but they've been hard at work already, picking up a little pieces of reeds and bringing it back to the nest. And it looks like this might be the female that has remained, and the male is flying backwards and forwards, bringing her building material. So he's bringing it and she's deciding where to put it. And it looks like they're building the chamber part of the nest now. Very elaborate nest builders are the hammerkops, and they will build a huge structure with only a small chamber actually on the inside where they nest, but they'll have a couple of false entrances as well and a false chamber, and that's obviously to put predators off, such as birds of prey and also some snakes, that once they come in and have a look and they see that that false entrance with its false chamber is empty, they think that nobody's home. Meanwhile, the hammerkops are quite happily carrying on safely in their real chamber. Now they'll build this chamber and then they do line it with mud, and then they'd start to pile a lot of reeds, more and more and more. So the actual structure is massive, but as I say, the chamber then that they actually live in is quite small. And they might build a few of these structures, and they don't necessarily accommodate them. They can just then use them as they move between. So it's normally around water where they have a very good food source, as well as lots of mud and reed that they use for the nesting material itself. And once it is built, with it being such a large structure, there are a lot of birds that can come and use it as their own nesting site, some of them nesting on top of it, some of them using the false entrances and actually then making a nest. And so it is absolutely amazing. Now, there is a lot of myths and legends around the hammerkop, and among certain African tribes, and the ones that I know in particular, the Zulus and the Xhosas in southern Africa, they believe that the hammerkop is the lightning bird. It manifests itself through lightning, and it becomes a small figure that can be slightly mean and nasty to these African tribes. So it is not a particularly good myth or legend that these local people have about the hammerkop, but very much related to rain and lightning and big thunderstorms, etc. So well, with us having that huge thunderstorm yesterday, last night, and with a lot of rain coming down, it's quite apt that we are sitting now with the hammerkops.